So we're on the road from Moorgab, and we've been blessed with an incredibly beautiful day. There's basically no wind for the first time in a while, which is absolutely amazing. It's making it so much more pleasant, and it's also surprising, as other cyclists have told us, all through this region was incredibly windy. But anyway, the main story for today is that this dog right here, hey, this dog right here, he's been following us, or running with us actually, for basically the whole day today, about 35 kilometers. So he actually, Yankee, left before us, and like an hour and a half before us. And when we caught up to her after 23 kilometers, we found that she had a dog with her. And she told us that he'd followed the whole way since Moorgab. And now he's taking turns to ride with me, with the other guys, with Yankee, or by himself. Sorry, to run, not ride. So, this little guy's going to sleep well tonight. He's had a big day. He has run, jogged, walked. How many kilometers? About 46 kilometers today. Very impressive efforts. Very impressive efforts. And we're not sure if he'll follow us tomorrow. We actually stopped at a little tiny village with like one house, two houses here for lunch. We asked if we could use a room to cook. We shelter because the wind picked up a bit, and we were planning to leave and keep going because it was still quite early, but in the end Raphael was a bit sick again and it getting cold very quick, so we've decided to stay here for the night, because whilst we were this close to deciding to go on, we also knew that there was a big chance we wouldn't find any other shelter, and it's probably going to be -5 or -10 tonight according to the forecast. So camping in that, not ideal. Well, after about 10 or 11 days or whatever it's been, maybe more, of riding along the same road, the famous M41 Pamir Highway, we have taken a turn to the left to do the Wakhan Valley, which is also quite famous, especially among travelers and cyclists and motorbikes. So this turn will take us right down along the border of Afghanistan, which is going to be very interesting. So we've just taken the turn, we're still of course a long way from that border, but we have a pass to climb to and pass over and go down today. We just stopped for lunch. Maybe you can see these guys behind me right there. Yeah, so some noodles and keep on moving. We've been pretty lucky with good weather in the last few days. Well, we've reached another pass, about 4,350, I believe. It's always a great achievement. This one, we've climbed higher. It was probably about a 600 meter climb, more or less, from where we started today. But this was still one of the hardest ones we've done, mainly because of the terrain, really loose gravel. And for me, with my weight, when it's quite steep, especially, my back tire just skids and it's really hard to get any grip on the road, on the surface. So this is one of the hardest ones. Feeling pretty proud. Really beautiful up here. As you can see, there's a nice lake behind me. Check this out. Got the sunset basically just behind the mountain. It's getting really cold, but yeah, super beautiful. We're gonna go about 10 kilometers downhill, and apparently there's shelter, like an army base or something. So yeah, feeling good. Another pass down on the Pamir Highway in Tajikistan. Woo! Say hello to Raphael.
It's so beautiful!
We got onto really shitty roads, climbed up to a pass at about 4,350, and then did another 10 kilometers of really rough downhill. And by that time it was starting to get dark, and we knew from our map that there was shelter and water, but we didn't know exactly what it was at this 10 kilometer mark. So finally we got here, it was getting dark, and realized it was all quite abandoned. There's a bunch of old buildings, but they're all locked, so we couldn't get into any of them. And there's a huge army base, but that's all fenced off on the other side. But I guess, yeah, we were looking around trying to figure out whether we're going to have to set up our tents in the freezing cold, or if we can get inside any of these buildings. And the other two guys were out looking up another spot when a couple of army guys came up and talked to me, because I guess they saw the flashlights. So we chatted for a while. The first and most important question was, are you from Israel? Which was quite funny. And then, yeah, we tried to converse for a little bit, and I kept trying to ask them where is the best place for us to sleep, and they were just kind of saying, yeah, it's going to be very cold in the tent. And they showed us a spot where there would be quite a bit of shelter, but then the other guys convinced me to ask them, oh, can we sleep like over with you? But they called the commander on radio. And then, next thing we know is they're like, well, there's this little checkpoint on the road that you guys could sleep in. So they took us over here, which is this absolutely tiny, tiny building. As you can see right here, it is absolutely tiny. Basically 1.5 meter squared building. This is the inside. Don't know how well you can see right now. Yeah, so three of us got all cozy in there, cooked last night. Super warm, it was nice. Really funny, the really young guys, they're in the army, they're I guess like 18 or 19. So they came over a couple of times, gave us some bread. Really friendly guys. So we've woken up now, 6:30, waiting for them to come back, because they're gonna have to use this building as a checkpoint for the road over here behind us. Super amazing view, by the way. Is that we were wondering why the military base was so close here. We didn't think we were that close to Afghanistan yet, but we've just realized it's literally right there, right behind the river. So not as far as those mountains, there's a river. Not sure how well you can see on the camera, but that's Afghanistan. Although that is a very peaceful area. Afghanistan, no problems. Doesn't involve itself in any of the war or anything. So yeah, we're going to be riding along the border basically all day today for the next few days. Pretty cool. Oh, Oh man, these roads in the Wakan Valley are so tough. Either it's really rocky, and even with the mountain bike, I can't go fast because of all the luggage, or it's really loose gravel and sand. So like this right here, look at that. You cannot get any grip, and the bike is just sliding around. I don't know if you can see my skid marks behind me. It's just woo, almost falling over. It's really challenging, yeah. Man, holy shit, this terrain has just gotten worse. Now it's all, not sure how well you can see this, but hard rock, so lumpy. My bags just keep falling off. It's really dangerous, it's hard, I can't get any speed. But on a better note, on the other side of that river, as I've told you already, that is Afghanistan. Wow, it's super cool to be here. Yeah, not many of you watching this can say you've been on the border of Afghanistan.
Yeah, it will do.
So here's a close-up of the river that is the border between Tajikistan and Afghanistan. So right there on the other side, that is Afghanistan. I would like at some point, if it's quite narrow to and there's no one else around, to somehow try and get across, just to stand in the other side. But right here it's way too wide and the water would be absolutely ice cold, so it would not be a good idea. But a lot of this region is super remote, so it might be possible at some point. That'd be pretty cool, just to say being in Afghanistan. On the road, and we met this Tajik guy and his wife. We were standing out there and got talking to them a little bit. And they live here, quite a bit off the road, like about a kilometer off the road. So they invited us to come over. So we thought we'd go, because it was about lunchtime anyway. We cooked some lunch, we cooked our own lunch. He has a really nice home, he's a really interesting guy. He has a bunch of English books actually, including probably my favorite book ever, which is The Long Walk, an incredible true story about. I think they were Polish guys, it's a movie as well, Polish guys who escaped from a Soviet prison camp and walked all the way through Siberia, Mongolia, the Gobi Desert, through West China, Nepal, all the way to India. Anyway, he said he knows a little bit of English, he said he can understand a little bit of the books. But anyway, yeah, we sat here for a while and we kind of decided that we were going to actually stay the night here, because we misunderstood that one of the reasons that we came over to check out this place rather than continuing riding. So they told us that the famous Marco Polo sheep can be seen around here, and we thought he said like later this afternoon about 4 o'clock, just here we'd have to walk a little bit, and they're quite endangered now. I'll post a photo after this so you can check out, because they're amazing, and I thought we'd be able to see them along the Pamirs, but I think they're quite endangered, so they're hard to see now. When we asked about it again, we realized that he meant no, you'd actually have to walk way up into the mountains camp, keep walking for 2 or 3 days so you can see them. And then we actually said, oh, maybe we could hire you as a guide and pay you and go up for a couple of days, get off the bikes. But then he said, no, you actually need a permit to do that. Such a shame. But he has these really cool binoculars and telescope, and we were able to kind of get a glimpse of ibex, a few ibexes, which are kind of like antelopes, way up in the mountains. We couldn't really see them clearly, but still, that was really cool. So he seems like a really genuine guy, Tajik guy, very interesting. He said he knows, well, he knows Russian, of course, he knows Tajik, of course, he knows Kyrgyz, Kazakh, and apparently the Pamir language has its own language, Pamirski, Uzbek as well, so he knows about 6 languages and a little bit of English. It's very impressive, very interesting guy. And nice, it would be nice to stay here, but since we can't see these animals, we'll probably keep going today after Rafael is done with his fun with the drone. chill dog. This is possibly the most dangerous road I've ever ridden on. This is crazy. We're going quite steep downhill. The surface, again, like yesterday, is just super loose sand and rock, and it's impossible to go flat in a straight line. My bag just fell off again, as usual. The front one, the hooks just always fall off when it hits a really big bump, and it kind of throws me off. And to make it better, there's a massive cliff right next to me. No protection. It's a long way down, so yeah, this is tricky. Trying to be super careful. It's kind of frustrating having a good mountain bike but not really being able to go crazy because of the luggage. And yeah, you don't want to fall off the cliff, so yeah. We're almost back in civilization. We just passed through a little village. There's a few houses down there, so if I do fall down the cliff, I'm going to land in someone's backyard. And yeah, we've got a couple of k's to go. Incredible looking valley through here. As you can see, seeing some green again. Super nice with all the mountains, snowy mountains of Afghanistan on that side. So yeah, I'm gonna keep concentrating, getting this downhill done, and we'll make it to a town and we'll stop for the day. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. It's actually a video. Как вас зовут?
Ясина.
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 Morning. So we're camping right by the Afghan River, and we've just been woken up by some military who are telling us we need to go. We're not able to camp here. So luckily it's already 7:30 a.m. and we're all going to get up soon anyway, but we have to hurry up, pack and get out of here. So we managed to pack up and do everything, get out of there within about 20-25 minutes, so then all is good. They walked away. I guess it was just because we were too close to the border. But obviously we're not gonna cross it, it's way too deep and cold. So yeah, fun morning though. It made us get up super early. Other mornings where we're usually leaving around 10, today we left at 7:30, so that was nice. Cause I'm a morning person, I'm always waiting for the other guys to get up. Cool, we're on the way to Korog, quite close. There's a pizza restaurant apparently, that's gonna be nice, woo! Riding next to Afghanistan. Late in the day, we didn't have a proper lunch today, we didn't find anywhere to eat, had some snacks. So we just arrived in the town, it's getting kind of late, and found a little cafe. Turns out it's a big like wedding center, they're having a wedding tonight, so everything was all set up with loads and loads of food on each table. And I asked if we could order something just to take away, they said no, unfortunately we can't. And I asked nicely just if we could have any, if there was any spare food. They're like, okay, come on. So they've put us on a table now with loads of food. As you can see, there's a fruit bowl, big plate of chicken, amazing salad, bread, compote in a big beer glass, and tea, and yeah, absolute feast. And I have no idea how much we'll have to pay, or maybe they'll say don't worry about it. It'd be really cool if we could stay for the wedding as well. Who knows, maybe it'll happen if we eat slowly.
Yeah.
Let's see. Okay. Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
The cyclists that we met told us there was a spot along the road along the Afghan side of the border where they're digging into the rock, jackhammering and using dynamite to blow up a lot of rock. Not sure for what reason exactly, whether they're trying to build a tunnel through or just make a mine or something, but we've been wondering where this spot was and we finally found it. You probably can't see very well on the map, but it's right up there behind me. So we've just been taking some photos and watching them jackhammering, and two of the Afghan guys just signaled something to us. They saw us watching, but we don't know what they meant and if they're about to make an explosion, because that would be super awesome. So I think we're going to wait here and potentially camp here, even though there's nowhere to camp, just because we want to see it. That'd be amazing.
Man, I'm sure they're going to blow it.
Man, he's running the other way.
They're definitely about to do something. They're all signaling across the river to us to tell us to get out of the way, even though we're way across the river and they're super close. So something's definitely about to happen. It's freaking exciting. So we're getting well, more and more. Maybe back this way, he means. So yeah, this is, wow. I don't want to miss it, but they're about to freaking blow up a freaking cliff with dynamite. Whew. Let's see. Holy shit, that was intense. There were even some rocks that did come pretty much over here. Wow. Jesus. So cool, we are so lucky to get here right in that time. Damn, and I was standing on the grass behind and that river where the explosion was is like, well, 100 meters away, and there were rocks that nearly hit me. Nicola was down on this rock, and as soon as filming from this rock, and as soon as he saw one stone like flying, he hid right under the rock. But I didn't have anywhere to hide up there, so wow. What an experience. I guess we can tell people that we saw the Taliban blowing up stuff in Afghanistan, but technically this is
as they definitely know how to use explosives on
the Yeah, they're professionals. Although yeah, we were saying before they really don't have much safety equipment. The guys who did it just had to run back along the cliff. That is insane. So maybe we'll get some popcorn and sit down and wait for the next one. Is that worth it? Me? I'm really not sure. I hope so.
Это.
not
normal.
This trip has taken a very frustrating turn for the worse. A couple of days ago, right at the end of the day, I've got a puncture on my rear tire, which wasn't a big deal. But then the next morning, waking up while camping, and I had a puncture on the front tire. The front tire had gone flat, so I fixed that one. Anyway, went on to the next town where we had a rest day. Woke up the morning of the rest day and the same front one had gone flat again. Yesterday, we had a huge day. We climbed over 2,000 meters in one day in about 32 kilometers. So that was incredibly tough. It hasn't been a great night because I arrived at the pass with Nicola and he immediately got really sick. I don't know if it was from something he ate or drunk. But anyway, we survived the night. Now this morning, had a really good downhill. And then I noticed my rear tire has gone flat again. So I stopped right as we're getting to a village and we hadn't had any water or breakfast yet, so had to do that. Found there were two punctures on the same tube. I'm not sure what they were from, but my guess is that because my rear tire was really worn out. So in fixing them, I've also put my spare tire on. But both of the ones that I fixed, also the patches wouldn't stick. For some reason, I've done a really efficient job, is what I thought, but when I blew it up, air was coming out of it again. So I spent like almost 2 hours trying to fix that. Finally, we fixed it. We put the new tire in and taken off again, and it's going flat again. It's just very frustrating knowing that 95% of other cyclists have sourced their equipment in European countries or the West, and they all have the best brand of tires, which never get punctures. So it's very frustrating to suddenly get like four in 2 days of riding or 3 days of riding, and have to redo a lot of them as well. So yeah, the guys are ahead of me this time too, so I can't use Nicola's good pump. And yeah, I don't know, I'm just gonna maybe keep pumping it just to make it to the next village and hopefully find them there. So yeah, but that, and then as well, my front panniers keep falling off on these horrible roads, even though I've been putting some bungee cords around them. Sometimes even the cord comes off, and even one of the cords snapped, like the edge of it, the hook snapped before, just from the pressure or the way it. So lots of little shit going on that's very, very frustrating. But yeah, try and deal with it. That's all part of it, I suppose. It's over an hour later and I'm still here. And definitely not better off. In fact, I'm worse off than when I started. Basically, my pump is very terrible. I used to have a big one, a foot pump, but it broke. And I've been using Nicola's because he's got a good one, but he's ahead of me. So I've been trying to use this and I can't get anywhere, basically. It just won't inflate. Maybe there's still a tiny puncture, although I couldn't find one. I ended up taking it apart. I couldn't find it. And from pumping so much, and because this one is quite aggressive and it moves a bit, now the valve has snapped off, so this tube is screwed, despite being about 4 days old, or 3 days riding of use. So that's nice. Still here. It's been another hour or so since I last filmed. Seems like they're okay, although I just can't pump them fully enough, so I might just have to walk the next few kilometers to the village. Good day. Okay. Bye-bye. We'll be right back. Yo! So we're about 10 kilometers out of Dushanbe. Our trip along the Pamir Highway is done and dusted. I miss it already, getting to this dense, polluted, very populated area. A lot of dust, a lot of traffic. I miss the Pamirs already, the fresh air, the nature. But at the same time, super excited for a good shower, good food, good internet. It's been a while. Unfortunately, the riding with the two guys, Raphael and Nico, has been great. Unfortunately, it's going to be over, as they have different journeys. That earlier I was not wearing my helmet. I feel like a very bad role model. Please wear your helmets. The reason I wasn't, well, it's a quite safe city and I had to get some passport photos done, so I wanted to look nice. I didn't want to have some hat or helmet hair in the photo. It turns out the photo was kind of shit anyway. Although I realized after I took the photo, unfortunately too late, that this little center, they can Photoshop you into a suit, which would have been super cool.